Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. After years of constantly thinking about it and also constantly forgetting about it, last month I finally bought a new router, the TP-Link C80 AC1900. And today we're going to unbox it to find out what items are included in the package, go through TP-Link's super easy setup process, and do some product testing. Do take note though that if you're a PLDT Home Fiber subscriber, besides TP-Link's setup process, you may also want to change some things on the ISP provided Fiber Home Modem Router combo using its console to get it ready. Let's go! Here's the front of the box with some of its features. 1300 megabits per second or 130 megabytes per second connection on the 5 GHz band and 600 megabits per second or 60 megabytes per second connection on the 2.4 GHz band. Full gigabit ports, meaning all of its Ethernet ports is capable of 1 gigabit connection. 4 antennas for superior coverage, parental controls, and easy setup by Tether app. Here's what's on the back. Full gigabit ports, vast Wi-Fi coverage because of its 4 fixed high-performance antennas that form a signal-boosting array to cover more directions, and because of its beamforming technology which concentrates signal strength towards clients to expand Wi-Fi range. Smooth entertainment due to its airtime fairness and MU MIMO technology. Speeds of up to 1900 megabits per second. Quite confusing, isn't it? Basically, it's just the sum of 1300 megabits on the 5G and 600 megabits on the 2.4G connection. That's it! MU MIMO. MU MIMO technology lessens or eliminates the congestion of multiple devices trying to talk to it since it was built to talk to multiple devices at the same time, reducing the wait time and increasing Wi-Fi throughput and efficiency. Airtime fairness. Airtime fairness boosts the overall network performance by sacrificing a little bit of network time on the slowest devices. And smart connect. When enabled, the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz networks would share the same Wi-Fi name and password. They would appear as one SSID and your wireless device would automatically connect to which Wi-Fi band provides the fastest speed. Alright, let's open it up. Look at that. So just beside the power switch is the 12-volt DC input for power. This is the WAN or Wide Area Network port where we would connect the Ethernet cable that is connected to the ISP-provided router combo. And this is the LAN, Local Area Network, or Ethernet port where we would connect the Ethernet cable that is connected to our computer to grant it internet access. Basically, the ISP-provided router combo would be the main gateway to the internet. One of its LAN or Ethernet ports, which was previously connected to the computer, would then be connected to the new router's WAN port to provide access to the internet. And then, the new router would distribute the said access via its antennas for wireless connectivity and LAN ports for wired. Right over here is the WPS or Wi-Fi protected setup and the reset button. There are also some sort of cutouts at the bottom of it for hanging. Here's the 12 volts, 1.5 amps DC power supply. The Wi-Fi info card that contains the default SSID and password of the router and quick installation guide. Last but not the least is the included Cat5e Ethernet cable. Before we set it up using either the browser or the Tether app, we have to make sure that everything is properly connected and working first to avoid complications later on. First thing we need to do is to turn off the ISP-provided router combo. Okay, plug in the 12V DC barrel jack right here for power. Connect the Ethernet cable to the WAN port of the AC1900 and then connect the other end to one of the Ethernet ports of your modem, or in my case, the ISP-provided router combo. After that, get another Ethernet cable and connect your computer to one of the Ethernet ports on the AC1900. Like so. Then, let's plug in the power supply for the AC1900 and turn on the ISP-provided router combo. Okay, so let's just wait for the ISP router to connect to the internet before we turn on the AC1900. This is the SSID of the old router combo. As you can see here, my phone is connected to it, meaning it's already connected to the internet. Alright, let's turn this thing on and wait for it to configure itself for first use. There it is! Seems like all is in good condition. This is the power indicator, 2.4 GHz connection or signal, 5G connection, LAN or Ethernet connection, and of course, internet connection. Now that we have finished setting up its hardware, let's move on to the software. According to its quick installation guide, we can set it up in two ways, via the TP-Link Tether app and via the browser. For this one, I'm going to go with the browser setup first, since I need to change some settings on the ISP-provided router combo's console anyway. First up, let's access the router's console by typing 192.168.1.1 on the browser's address bar. After logging in, let's turn off the radio broadcast of the ISP-provided router combo. To do that, let's go to the Network tab and set the radio to off. Turning the radio broadcast to off would make the router only act as a modem and not broadcast Wi-Fi signal. As you can see here, it's still giving me access to the internet because my desktop PC is using wired connection. But if I try to connect to it using Wi-Fi, the ISP router's SSID does not show up. And if I turn it on, there it is. After turning off the radio broadcast of the ISP's router, let's set up the AC1900 next. Okay, let's enter 192.168.0.1. There it is. Let's get started. Set up the time zone. Select connection type. I think it's dynamic, but since I'm not sure, let's click on auto detect. Oh, I guessed right. Click next. For this one, I'm going to use the default. Click next. Now let's change the SSID of the router. For the sake of the test, I'm just going to use TP-Link Archer C80 2.4G for the 2.4G connection and TP-Link Archer C80 5G for the 5G one. And let's just use the default Wi-Fi password at the moment. Click next, wait for it to finish setting up, and we're good to go. Click next. I'm going to skip this for now, so on the network map, we can see who and what devices are connected. At the moment, it only has one device connected, and that is my desktop PC. Alrighty then, let's do some speed tests now, shall we? First, let's check the Wi-Fi connection speed of the ISP-provided router combo using my mobile phone. Keep in mind that the router combo can only provide 2.4 GHz connection. So now that it's connected and can already be seen on the client's list, let's begin the test using speed test. And go! 2 milliseconds ping, 33.1 megabits per second download and 44.1 megabits upload speed. 33.1 megabits is just around 3 megabytes and 44.1 megabits is 4 megabytes. Which is not really that bad, but still slow as heck. Now let's compare it with the Archer C80's 2.4G connection speed. And go! 1 millisecond ping, 64.8 megabits per second download and 77.2 megabits of upload speed. As you have probably noticed, both the download and upload speed increased by almost 100%. The question is, how come the connection speed on the ISP-provided router combo is slower compared to the Archer C80, even though the mobile device is connected to the same 2.4 GHz band? To put it simply, the ISP-provided router combo is, well, a combo. Which means that both the modulation and demodulation of the modem inside it and the Wi-Fi signal broadcasting or distribution is handled by just one CPU. Besides the fact that the Archer C80 CPU workload is lessened because the ISP-provided router combo handles the modulation and demodulation for it and only needs to focus on Wi-Fi signal broadcasting or distribution, the Archer C80 also has another advantage called MU-MIMO or Multi-User, Multi-Input, Multiple Output technology. TLDR, the Archer C80 is brand new and has higher specs. Now let's test the 5G connection. 2 milliseconds ping, 230 megabits download and 330 megabits upload speed. And that's it for the quick browser setup. Now, just in case you wanted to control the router using TP-Link's Tether app as well, let's sign up for our TP-Link ID and cloud service. And while we're at it, let's do another speed test but this time using the desktop PC. Let's start with the wired connection. By the way, I have re-enabled the ISP router combo's radio or Wi-Fi broadcast capability for these first few tests, and the Ethernet cable is connected to the Archer C80. 1 millisecond ping, 93.42 megabits per second download, and 94.72 megabits per second of upload speed. Let's disable the Ethernet connection for it not to interfere and then enable and connect to the Wi-Fi. 3 milliseconds ping, 118.37 megabits per second download, and 126.25 megabits per second of upload. Now let's connect to the 2.4G bandwidth of the Archer C80. 2 milliseconds ping, 56.13 megabits per second download and 26.57 megabits per second upload. Alright, let's try the 5G one. 2 milliseconds ping, 212.98 megabits per second download and 84.32 megabits per second upload. Interesting. I wonder why the Wi-Fi connection speed is faster than the wired one despite having fiber connection and using gigabit LAN. I'm confused. Just to be thorough, I have connected the Ethernet cable back to the ISP provided router combo and did another test. But the wired connection speed is just about the same as before. I'm not sure if it has something to do with the timing of the test though, because it's peak hours since it's the afternoon, or if I did not set it up correctly, and our internet plan is just up to 100 megabits per second anyway, so it's understandable, I guess? I just don't get why the Wi-Fi connection seems to be faster. My guess is that they're using different testing parameters and therefore getting vastly different results. I'm not that sure though. To set up the Tether app, you can download it using Play Store for Android devices and the App Store for iOS. Search for Tether and then click on Download and Install. After that, launch the app and then log in using the TP-Link ID that we have created earlier. Click on Login. Wait for it to configure itself and then click on the router. On the left side is the status of your connection and on the right side are the number of clients connected. As you can see here, the only client or device that is connected is the desktop computer. Now, just to see if it would update, I'm going to connect to it using my mobile phone. Let's log into it again and there we go. Okay, give me a sec, I'm just going to connect all of our devices here. Now that everything is connected to it, let's explore the app a little bit. So if we click on Tools, we will see some of the things that we already did on the browser version, like Quick Setup, Wi-Fi SSID and Password Setup, Internet Connection Details and Status and other things. Parental Control can be used to block websites and set time limits on internet access, like for example, you set a daily limit of 2 hours internet usage for your child. When you activate it, it would automatically kick the device that is connected to it, basically disconnecting it from the internet when the time limit has been reached. Same thing goes for the bedtime option, albeit a little different, because it has a little bit more freedom to it since internet access is only removed during bedtime or from X time PM to X time AM. You can, of course, choose not to use it or customize it to your liking. Network diagnostics is used when you want to find out what is wrong with your connection. For example, when your internet speed suddenly dropped, you can use this to check and see what the problem is. And as you can see here, it's currently running smoothly. Guest network is for, well, guests. Subarashii. When enabled, this would let them connect to our Wi-Fi without the need for them to know the password or connect to our private network. It's like an isolated or sandboxed connection. You could also add a bandwidth limit to it. Share Wi-Fi is just a way for us to share our Wi-Fi password without typing it to another device. We just have to scan the QR code using the device that we want to connect and we're good to go. We can also share the QR code via Bluetooth, email, messages, and the like. Or even print it and then post it on a wall. TP-Link Wi-Fi ID is when we want to entrust our network to someone else other than us. LED control is for us to turn the status LEDs on or off. Operation mode is when we want to change it from router mode to access point mode. On the System tab, we can manage our passwords and reboot the router without physically turning it off and on, remotely update our router's firmware and restore it to factory settings. And as you can see here, there is an available firmware update. Alright, let's update it. Who knows, maybe it would fix the connection speed issue that we're having earlier. And it's done. For some reason, it changed the SSID and password. So for now, I just use the temporary SSID and password that TP-Link has given. You can see it here on the wireless tab. Alright, let's see if the firmware update has fixed the connection speed issue. Let's try doing a speed test using the desktop PC. 1 millisecond ping, 208.36 megabits per second download and 99.75 megabits upload. The wired connection speed certainly did increase quite a bit when we compare it to the pre-firmware update results. Almost as fast as the 5G connection now. After that, let's set up the SSID and password again, click on next, wait for it to configure, click next, log into TP-Link's cloud service and there we go. We can also set up NAT forwarding, QoS, security, and IPv6 here. These settings are only available on the web management page, and these are for more advanced users, so I won't tackle them here. And yeah, that's all for today, guys. Thanks for watching, and see you again next week. Maybe.